Hey, everyone. Welcome to another episode of Investing Kev. In today's 75th episode, I want to talk about NIO and show you how I've been dollar cost averaging since the start of the year. I want to show you some numbers of my purchases and my personal portfolio and some news about NIO in the future. For full disclosure, I own shares in NIO, been long on NIO, and will continue to remain long on NIO. We are 25 episodes away from 100 episodes. If you like this channel, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and let me know in the comments what you think. All right, everyone. Let's get started. I have this spreadsheet that I created of the dates that I've purchased NIO in 2022, the price of the stock when I purchased it, how many shares I got, and how much money I spent. If you want to take a look at this spreadsheet, the link will be in the description box below. I filled in the data for some dates while leaving most blank just to show you the fluctuations and how much money I spent. Back on January 14, 2022, I purchased 8 shares of NIO at $31 and the cost was around $249. A week later, on the 21st, NIO was at $28.77 and I purchased 1.4 shares, which cost me about $40. My investment strategy is simple. If I believe in a company, I want to build up my position as much as possible and go into it. To me, it doesn't matter how much money I have. What I care about is accumulating as many shares as I can in companies I believe in. I feel like on YouTube, you see a lot of investors consistently dropping thousands of dollars each time, and that can definitely impact your own journey as you compare yourself to others. So don't worry about that, focus on your own journey. And this is the power and flexibility of investing. If you have $5 to invest, you're still accumulating shares. I really have conviction in NIO, and I look at their future and I believe that I will be rewarded by playing the long game. No matter how little or many shares I purchase at once, I'm all in. In the middle of February, on the 15th, I made two purchases on the same day. NIO was $24 and I purchased 20.5 shares in the morning, and a few hours later I purchased 6.7 shares. At the end of February, I purchased 1.75 shares, and in mid-March I bought 67 shares on the 14th. This is an outlier because I sold out of one of my long-term dividend positions. The reason why I sold out was because I was over 100% in profits. I also saw an opportunity with NIO being at $14.69 per share. Buying that many shares at once is so rare and likely won't happen for a long time. In mid-April, I purchased 15 shares at $19 per share. And in the middle of May, I purchased 19 shares for $13. This was at NIO hitting its lowest in a long time. Now at the end of June, on the 30th, I purchased 5.7 shares at $21.68. This was back in early 2021. Like I said, I was buying NIO at $60 in the mid-40s when it was crashing. Those purchases I made at that time are down more than 50%. A few of them are down more than 60%. Now let's take a look at May 2022. This was when NIO was all the way down in the low 13s. I am up 60% on multiple purchases, up 50% on a few, and most of them are in the mid 20 to 30% range in terms of gains. I just want to show, like, dollar cost averaging is great in my opinion. The average share price over a 6-month period of purchasing was at $19.28. Back in January, NIO was around $31. We've seen the lows and now we're slowly trending back up. A lot of people talk about buying the dip when prices are low, but when prices are low, a lot of people are scared. If you follow me on Twitter, I've pretty much tweeted every time I've made a purchase on NIO. Talk is just talk, actions mean more, and that's where I'm at with NIO. I truly believe dollar cost averaging is a great investment strategy. Especially with these rocky times in the market, I've been able to lower down my average share price. A year and a half ago, I was buying NIO at $60, so my average share price is really high. I've kept chipping away and reducing my average share price to being a much more favorable average share price. My average share price has been in the 40s, down to the 30s, and it's currently in the mid-20s. Why do I remain bullish on NIO? Well, during NIO Day, they said by 2025, they'll have a lot more international exposure. I love their cars, I love their vision, and I love their management. I believe in their management's ability to take them where they need to be. This year, they'll be expanding to Germany, Netherlands, Sweden, and Denmark. On July 5th, NIO reached their 10 millionth battery swap in China. A day later, they'd reach 1,000 power swap stations. And at the end of May, NIO completed their construction of the modern assembly line at NIO Park. NIO Park construction started on April 29, 2021, and NIO is one of the largest members of the hub. The 16,950-acre park features three main function areas: smart manufacturing, R&D and living space, and eco park. NIO Park will have production capacity for 1 million electric cars and 100 gigawatt hours of batteries per year on an area of 11.3 square kilometers. And back in June, NIO delivered 12,961 vehicles, which was a new monthly record. Back in June 2021, they delivered 8,083 vehicles. 1 year later, they've almost delivered 5,000 more vehicles. That's all I have for you. I just want to show you my 2022 progress in dollar cost averaging into NIO and why I remain excited. Let me know if you're invested in NIO and if you've been dollar cost averaging. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and let me know in the comments what you think. As always, thank you for tuning in, stay safe, and I'll see you all next time.